Every year, some cheeky brewers with high-pitched voices post videos claiming they've made beer with helium instead of CO2 or nitrogen. Then internet nerds expose the videos as pranks. What gets lost in this perpetual cycle, though, is that you can't actually make helium beer. Stay tuned to see how our friends did it, and why some skeptics didn't think it was possible. People often debunk the prank videos by invoking helium's poor solubility in water, which is beer's main ingredient. But some folks think helium's solubility is so low.
How low is it?
So low that you can't force any helium to dissolve in beer, and that's not exactly true. To explain, we've got a duo responsible for some real helium beer. C&EN beer aficionado Craig Bettenhausen and home brewmaster Kevin Wepasnick. Kevin's also a surface scientist with Anderson Materials Evaluation, which is where we went to get skinny. How tight is that logo? Oh, and we're not going to get into how to brew beer. We've already covered that in this video, and this one, and this one. Craig and Kevin crafted a normal, delicious beer, then at the end, they pressurized the keg with helium instead of brewing's most common gases, CO2 or nitrogen. Anyhow, back to helium solubility. Take it away, fellas.
It has some solubility.
To be fair, nothing is insoluble. Everything has some degree of solubility.
But how does helium solubility stack up against nitrogen and carbon dioxide?
From a molarity standpoint, it's about a half an order of magnitude less soluble than nitrogen, and two orders of magnitude?
Yeah,
less than carbon dioxide.
Carbon dioxide can actually chemically react with water to form carboxylic acid in solution. And then through this process, it actually increases its solubility.
Helium, especially, helium makes no chemical reaction whatsoever with the water.
So helium's kind of like nitrogen, an inert gas that's way less soluble than CO2. And brewers use nitrogen all the time. You've probably heard about nitro brews or know about the widget that releases nitrogen gas inside Guinness cans. So you might be wondering, how is helium beer different from nitrogen beer? Well, it's not really. Both beers are flat because they're not carbonated, but they're less acidic than carbonated beer, meaning you get a richer, creamier, more velvety beverage. So you can make helium beer, but the bottom line is it offers no advantage over conventional beers. It doesn't even raise your voice. It is not a fizzy lifting drink. I say good day, helium.
If we were to do this again, I wouldn't bother wasting the helium. I mean,
there's definitely a helium shortage. It's one of the biggest problems facing the scientific world, I think, or the chemistry world anyway. We've got serious medical instruments that need helium, and serious analytical instruments, NMRs, that are doing some of the groundbreaking science that need the helium a lot more than this beer does. That said, it's a very small amount of helium. For a fun experiment for a magazine, worth it. On a regular basis, you would never want to make a helium beer.
Huge thanks to Craig, Kevin, and Anderson Materials Evaluation for making this video possible. Be sure to check out Craig's fantastic story for more info on the helium brew, including a recipe. And all you beer snobs out there, what's the strangest brew you've ever tried? Soddy? Sour beer? Dung-smoked whale testicle beer? Tell us about it in the comments.